Howdy gamers, how's it going? Jester back with a almost like an old style Jester video. It's been a while since I've kind of sat here and talked in front of a camera, but I wanted to give a bit of an update about what's going on, why I haven't uploaded in a while, and why I've kind of not been answering DMs. In short, life just got up to a bit of fucker shit. I've never been the most mentally well-off person. I've always had my struggles, and that's okay. I'm in a way better place now than I was in a while. And for some of you guys that don't know, I have OCD and a fairly moderate case of it. It's not like crazy severe, but it's definitely the most pronounced of my mental illnesses that I collect like Pokemon cards. And I had a really obtrusive thought I kept obsessing about. Starting maybe 5 months ago, this would have been in May of this year, and it was just kind of the part that loneliness was getting me really bad, and then the thought that kept appearing in my head is like, oh, my life is a piece of shit, and I finally got to feel what my dream is. And that was the YouTube stuff doing well. Like, it still makes my day. And I have this validation now that I never had, where I can look and I have people DMing me all the time and people leaving comments and people usually saying incredibly nice things. And it's helped me a lot. But in reality, this isn't my job. And I have a full-time job outside of this, which is humbling. But around 5 months ago, also, I was laid off from my job, and at the same time, this thought kept appearing in my head where I was like, I got to feel like what I wanted in my life. Like, I got to experience mentally and have this crazy euphoria for probably around 6 months where I was the happiest I was in my entire life. And I thought, like, hey, my life for the most part, it hasn't been great. It's not, I'm not gonna go in my full life story, but it's not been easy. And I don't mean to draw pity for myself, like other people have it way worse. But it went from being pretty pissed at myself and where I was in life to having what I dreamed I would have. Overnight, that happened. And so this obtrusive thought kept happening in my head where I was like, I got what I wanted out of my life. There's no reason to keep on going. And this kept happening. And I was laid off from my job. And I'm like, okay, I know this isn't healthy. And so I decided, to call a mental health screener with the previous services that I used to have, trying to explain the situation. And I was a little too honest about some suicidal thoughts, and I ended up in the psych ward. And I was on welfare at the time. And without going into details about my adventures at the psych ward, which maybe I will another day, just for the tone of this video, like I almost got pussy, but I backed out last second. It was not my proudest moment. But I did the right thing about backing out. But regardless, I ended up in the mental health unit of the hospital. And as I was at the mental health unit in the hospital, I had my workplace from 2 times ago, the one before I was laid off, that contested my unemployment claim, saying that I did not quit with rightful cause, and because I was at the hospital part of the time, and then the part I was home, I was readjusting, and I was dealing with a lot of stuff and going to a lot of hospital stuff. Like, I wasn't checking my email. I didn't even know they tried to conflict it, and I didn't receive any physical mail, or else I would have noticed. And so that week ended up, and so they automatically determined it in the favor of my workplace. And then also, I didn't even know that happened until I went to look at my bill at the hospital. I saw I had a $6,000 hospital bill for something I didn't consent to going to. And then at the same time, I now had a $3,500 bill from the Missouri Department of Labor, all out of nowhere. And I was already in this really bad place, and now I'm $9,500 in the hole. And it has been really difficult because it's not easy to deal with those things. I don't have the money anywhere near it. I'm not asking for money. I'm not going to put up a fucking GoFundMe or whatever the fuck people use. I don't care. Other people need the money way more than I do. And I'm not trying to give a sob story for that. I'm trying to explain why I've been gone. And so that was taxing. And I have another full-time job now. And my full-time job is it's very humbling, I'll say that. It's not quite as physically or mentally exhausting as other stuff I've had. It's not the worst job I've had. But it's still, with all the stuff that's going on and working a full-time job, it's fairly difficult to come home and stream every day like I was for over a year. Because I'm essentially allocating 90 hours of my week to being productive, is what it usually came out to, with editing and streaming and working full-time. And so I essentially had zero free time. And what I often do in times like now, where it's been mentally difficult, is I'll like drown myself in an MMO. A little bit towards the beginning, it was WoW. I did things with TBC Classic I'm somewhat proud of. I nearly got top 100 Resto Shamans in the world, and now I'm playing old school RuneScape. I've just been playing so much fucking old school RuneScape, man. I like. Like 16 hours a day when I'm not working, and when I'm working, it's just like from when I wake up till I have to leave for work. So I've been upkeeping pretty much everything to be an adult. Like I still do all my adult things. Like I go to work, I pay my bills, and I'm getting myself back on my feet financially, because I was also in an extremely hard place financially for a while because I wasn't receiving unemployment, I didn't have a job, and so I was in a really bad place there for a while. But I'm at least okay now financially, with the fact that I still have this $9,500 bill hanging over my head. I don't think I'm gonna get in legal trouble about it, but I might have collections agencies going after me. I don't know. I'm not used to being in debt. I always pay all my bills. I always pay off my credit card. I've never went so. And also, yeah, I don't need to keep repeating myself, but yeah, so I'll probably get back to stuff soon. And what I do plan on getting back to is most likely documentary style content. I don't think I have the. It's difficult for us. Sometimes I can muster it up, like right now, to record, but most days it's pretty difficult recently to do much other than just like exist. So. And I'm also a lot busier than I was before. Now with the doctor stuff too, because I'm back in the system, so I have like multiple doctor's appointments a week sometimes. And I'm just a lot busier than I was before. So it's hard to stream right now. But once I get myself in a better place mentally, and I'm working on it pretty hard, I plan on working on documentary stuff. I have a really, really awesome project that got kind of far along before shit hit the fan, and so I plan on finishing that. But yeah, if it's not a while, maybe a couple months again, at least, until I upload something, just know that I'm most likely okay. I shouldn't say most likely. I'm fine. I'll be okay. Like I've the reason I was worried about uploading this video is because I didn't want people to worry, and I feel like not knowing anything would pe almost be a better peace of mind than knowing what is happening, but other people have it way worse. Just know that I've been through shitty times before, and this is not the worst it's been. It's just not rock bottom for me. I have been lower. So I'll be okay. I'll dig myself out of this hole, but it's gonna be a lot of work. And so, yeah. But yeah, hope you guys just understand why I'm not uploading, and maybe this will slow down the people that are worrying. But I'm really worried it's gonna have an adverse effect to people worrying. Whatever. I probably can't even be fucked to really edit this, so this is just gonna get raw ass MP4 uploaded into YouTube, because you can go fuck yourself. But I love you gamers. Bye. Mwah.